Welcome to Vocabulary TV. This is our 26th video on roots, prefixes and suffixes in English vocabulary. The theme for this video are the Latin roots mort and mord, which can best be memorized from the phrase mortui non mordent, a Latin phrase that translates as dead men don't bite. Well, the first root mort means death and mord means bite. So apart from similar spellings, there goes the connection between them. In this video lesson, we shall be covering dozens of important words in English derived from these roots. So let's start. The most common word based on the root is mortal. Literally speaking, anyone subject to death is mortal. Like man is a mortal being. And even in best cases, one must cover the distance from cradle to a grave and go through various life stages. Though even among men, we sometimes humorously use the phrase lesser mortals to bring out the contrast with others who have lower status or abilities. An example would be a king talking to his subjects. I am the king, and so I shall have the last laugh, not you. And he's calling them lesser mortals. In another meaning, mortal can describe something which is fatal and can cause death. For instance, in a mortal combat, his enemy inflicted a mortal wound on his left shoulder, thus injuring him mortally. In contrast, immortal is someone who is not subject to death. Like, we can say that gods and goddesses are immortal beings. Immortal can also describe such things which live forever or eternally. As we believe, our mortal bodies are inhabited by immortal souls. And someone might be of an immortal fame, like perhaps Gandhiji. If we add the suffix "-ize" to immortal, we get the word immortalize, which literally means to cause someone to become immortal. And an example sentence would be, as the father of the nation, Gandhiji will be forever immortalized in our history books. The related words describing their respective qualities are mortality and immortality. And while mortality is the state of being subject to death, we sometimes use this word in the phrase mortality rates to refer to death, especially on a large scale. Like, we can say that a region which has suffered an epidemic outbreak will have a higher mortality rate. And immortality is, of course, the ability to live forever. You will perhaps encounter these words in passages like these. Most people find it difficult to come to grips with the concept of mortality or the fact that death will claim us all one day. They would go to great lengths to remain young and would like to believe that with the advances in science and medicine, we might achieve immortality one day. Coming to some more easy words derived from the root mort, we have mortuary and mortician. Well, mortuary or the funeral home is a room or building which is a temporary abiding place of the dead person until he is entombed or cremated. And the word mortician refers to the funeral director or the undertaker who is in charge of such death ceremonies. A sentence exemplifying both words would be, the body, once identified, was removed from the mortuary and a mortician was appointed at once to take care of further proceedings. Now, handling a dead body is not easy. The relatives, or in some cases the mortician, must deal with rigor mortis or the stiffness that death brings to the limbs of a corpse, which makes them difficult to move. Sometimes a dead body will even require a postmortem or an examination after death to determine why that person died. By extension, we can use the word postmortem in other contexts, like when we are analyzing an event soon after it occurred to determine why it went wrong. For instance, the party leaders called an after-elections meeting to do a postmortem of why it lost. Next, we have the dreadful sounding term mortgage, which literally means debt pledge. When a person conveys his property such as his house to a creditor, such as a bank, as security on a loan, he is said to have mortgaged his house. A mortgage or a debt pledge is called that way because if a mortgager or the one who holds the debt pledge fails in his promise to pay off his house's mortgage, the property then becomes forfeit or debt to him and he can no longer live there. The mortgager gets back his property papers only when the debt is paid off. So, in an extended meaning, mortgage could be used when we expose something to a future risk or constraint for the sake of immediate advantage. For example, some people worry that privatizing state assets mortgages the country's future. And one of the most important words derived from the root is mortify. The word would literally mean to make someone dead. Though we are not talking about an actual death here, but rather the death to someone's pride. If someone is mortified, he or she is feeling very embarrassed or ashamed. For example, the kid was mortified when he realized that he had wetted his pants in school. In a second meaning, mortify is to cause the death of your desires, that is, to subdue the body or its needs and its desires by self-denial or discipline. For instance, ascetics like him choose to mortify their flesh and give up on all worldly pursuits in search of God. The related noun is mortification, which means great embarrassment and shame. Mortification is what you would probably feel when you walk into a party wearing a funny bunny costume and realize that everyone else is formally dressed. By the way, I am quoting this example from the movie The Bridget Jones Diary. And the last of these words derived from mort is moribund. If someone or something is moribund, it's in a death-like state or just about to die. Moribund can describe a person or even an animal which is at the point of its death. Like the bird here seems moribund. The moribund is more commonly used for things such as a dying industry, which is in its terminal decline and lacks vitality or vigor. The best example that occurs to me is the shift that we have witnessed in the photography industry year 2000 onwards. From analog or film-based to digital imaging, with even smartphones having the camera functionality nowadays. This created huge problems for many camera manufacturers, like we now know that Kodak went bankrupt, and we can only infer that compact cameras or analog imaging is now a moribund industry. Coming to the second root in this lesson, the Latin root mordere means to bite, from which we derive the word morsel, which is a common one. A morsel of food means a small bite or amount of food, that is a mouthful of food. For example, Arya chewed on a morsel of toast in her mouth. By extension, morsel could also mean a small piece or amount of anything. Like we can say that for the cricket team, which lost 0-3 in their homeland to the visiting team, there wasn't even a morsel of consolation. Next word is remorse. Literally, when something bites your conscience again and again, that's remorse. So remorse means a deep regret or guilt for a wrong committed. When one is full of remorse, he or she can be described as remorseful. For instance, he was filled with remorse for what he had done. The same sentence can be rephrased as, he was remorseful for what he had done. In contrast, when one is without any remorse, especially when one should be guilty or regretful, we would use the word remorseless to describe that person. Like in this sentence, everyone at the party was awestruck as they watched him gobbling up one brownie after another remorselessly. The word remorseless could also be used for something unpleasant, which is never ending or improving, and is relentless, such as remorseless poverty. But perhaps the most celebrated word based on the root mordere is mordant. typically used for humor or wit that is biting and harshly critical and yet funny. Here, I am quoting Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who, in a comment, apparently for Rahul Gandhi, displayed his mordant sense of humor in saying that some people grow older but not wiser. The word can also be used for chemicals that treat fabrics by fixing dyes or stains on the material. Look at this funny picture. Another instance of mordant wit as a suggestion that can bite you. And our last word in this lesson is mordacious. It is used to describe someone who is characterized by its biting habits, such as a mordacious dog. But in its prime meaning, mordacious is something that denotes or uses a biting sarcasm or invective. For instance, the lady's mordacious look showed plainly that she hated us all. Now test your understanding of the words learnt in this lesson by filling in the blanks below. It is recommended that you pause the video when the timer starts. And that brings us to the end of this video. Hope you liked it. Subscribe our channel and stay tuned for more such videos. Thank you.